Dear friends, wish you a very happy and prosperous 2023. This is the season of happiness. On one hand, we have stepped into a new year with new dreams and projects. On the other, our own Sankranti festival is coming up. So, this is the time when we give little gifts to friends and relatives and also receive gifts from others. So, today let us see a story about giving presents. O.Henry is a well-known American writer who is famous for his short stories. One of his famous short stories is The Gift of the Magi. It is a heartwarming story of a young couple who have a formidable task ahead of them. They have to buy Christmas presents for each other. But the problem is they have very little money. The story of the couple, poor in materialistic possessions, but rich in love and affection for each other, has won the hearts of the readers since decades. It is the day before Christmas. Della counts her money thrice. She only has $1.87, an amount she has saved up with great effort. But the small amount cannot buy a decent gift for her dear husband. There are only two prized possessions in the house. One, a gold pocket watch, which belonged to her husband, Jim's grandfather and father. Two, Della's hair, which would put Queen of Sheba's jewels to shame. Della sees her reflection in a glass. Her gaze shifts to her hair. Immediately she pulls down her hair, which falls about her, rippling and shining like a cascade of brown waters. It reaches below her knee and almost makes itself seem like a garment for her. She immediately steps out and reaches a shop where hair is bought. Without a moment's hesitation, she sells her hair for $20 and immediately going to a gift shop, picks up a platinum chain for Jim's pocket watch for $21. When Jim comes home and stares at her with a peculiar expression, she runs to him and says, "Don't look at me that way. I had my hair cut off and sold it because I couldn't have lived through Christmas without giving you a present. It'll grow out again. You won't mind, will you? I just had to do it. My hair grows awfully fast. Say Merry Christmas, Jim, and let's be happy. You don't know what a beautiful, nice gift I have bought for you." "You have cut off your hair," asks Jim laboriously. "Cut it off and sold it," says Della. "Don't you like me just as well anyhow? I am me without my hair, ain't I?" Jim takes out a package from his overcoat pocket and throws it on the table. Don't make any mistake, Del, he says. About me, I don't think there's anything in the way of a haircut or a shave or a shampoo that could make me like my girl any less. But if you will unwrap that package, you may see why you had me going a while at first. As Della tears open the package, she screams with joy and then starts wailing hysterically. Do you know what she sees? A set of 3 expensive, bejeweled hair accessories she had longed to possess. Her heart had simply craved and yearned for them without the least hope of possession. And now they are hers. But the tresses that should have adorned the coveted adornments are gone. Eventually, she manages to smile and remarks, "But my hair grows so fast, Jim." She then realizes that Jim hasn't seen the gift she had purchased for him. She holds it in her open palm and says, "Isn't it a dandy, Jim? I hunted all over the town to find it. You will have to look at the time 100 times a day now. Give me your watch. I want to see how it looks on it." Instead of obeying, Jim tumbles down on the couch and, putting his hands under the back of his head, smiles at her. "Del," he says, "let's put our Christmas presents away and keep them a while. They are too nice to use just at present. I sold the watch to get the money to buy your gift." The story ends with the words, "The Magi, as you know, were wise men, wonderfully wise men, who brought gifts to Jesus. They invented the art of giving Christmas presents. Being wise, their gifts were no doubt wise ones. And here I have lamely related to you the uneventful chronicle of 2 foolish children in a flat who most unwisely sacrificed for each other the greatest treasures of their house. But in a last word to the wise of these days, let it be said that of all who give gifts, these 2 were the wisest. Of all who give and receive gifts, such as they are wisest. Every way they are wisest. They are the Magi." This sentimental story has won the hearts of millions across the globe and continues to be an ideal for selfless love even today. Do try to read more stories of O. Henry whenever possible. Stay tuned to Achala Vismaya Loka for more such stories and interesting information. Thank you.